Hello everybody and welcome back to yet another travel vlog, and this time I am headed to Udaipur. This is my airport outfit and here I am at the international airport, and quickly we did all of the security check and headed to the lounge where I had absolutely delicious food. So first up is this chicken sandwich which was so nice, and then this biryani and this pakoda thing which I did not like much. Then I had one cappuccino, and this is what I had at the lounge. While I had cappuccino, my parents had a cup of tea, and after that we headed towards our gate. It was an evening flight, so I got to witness this absolutely beautiful sunset, and while enjoying the sunset I boarded the plane, and here is a beautiful takeoff. The view of the Mumbai city is just breathtaking from the top. After a good flight, I landed in Udaipur, and this is a little tour of the Chunda Palace where I stayed. It is this beautiful palace-like resort, and I really liked the details and such beautiful artwork on the ceiling and carefully painted by these Rajasthani workers. And yeah, soon I'll be showing you a little room tour. Here it is. So this is the room we stayed in. It's so beautiful, spacious, and I literally felt like a queen staying in this room. Since it was Diwali time, the entire Udaipur city was lit up with beautiful lights, and we went on the rooftop of this restaurant, and I got to see the beautiful view of the city which was just lit up, and wherever I went I saw little diyas. We had a light dinner and went to bed because the next day was jam-packed. Hello everybody, it is day 1 at Udaipur, and I'm all ready. I'm done with my makeup and I'm gonna soon get ready and go to the city palace. My lipstick shade is from Lavath in the shade Citrus Cosmo. So it is this tiny one, so I'm going to carry this in my backpack, and I have used the Pore Professional super setting spray from Benefit. So this is a makeup setting spray because I've done a full face makeup and I needed that, and yeah, the rest of the products that I used are almost the same as always. I'm gonna quickly open my suitcase up and I'm gonna show you what I'm gonna wear today. It is this beautiful chicken curry suit. It is off-white, and I'm gonna style it with jeans and oxidized jewelry. So here are the outfits for 3 days, and I'm gonna show you every single day what I wear. I'm quickly going to change and show you. I'm all dressed. This is my outfit and these beautiful peacock earrings. I'm real quick gonna show you my jewelry pouch. I've got tons of jewelry for all the outfits. So here's my jewelry. I am going to wear this layered bangle. And here is the bracelet in all its glory. I am all ready and I'll meet you at the city palace. Our driver was really sweet and he explained us everything along the way. And when we reached City Palace, we got our tickets, headed straight to the palace. So it was a little walk because on that particular day, they weren't allowing cars to go right at the top. I was absolutely mesmerized seeing the City Palace. Of course, the whole palace is not open to the public, only a small part of it is turned into a museum, and this palace is overlooking the Lake Pichola. And yes, the view is absolutely gorgeous from here. City Palace was built over a period of nearly 400 years with contributions from several rulers of the Mewar dynasty. Its construction began in 1553, started by Maharana Uday Singh II of the Sisodia Rajput family as he shifted his capital from the erstwhile Chittor to the newfound city of Udaipur. We also ended up doing a little mini photo shoot with authentic Rajasthani clothes on, and we got this done inside the palace premises itself. The City Palace was built in a flamboyant style and is considered the largest of its type in the state of Rajasthan. It was built atop a hill in a fusion of Rajasthani Rajput architecture, providing a panoramic view of the city and its surroundings. The unique aspect of this conglomeration is that the architectural design is distinctly homogeneous. The palace complex has been built entirely in granite and marble. The interiors of the palace complex, with its balconies, stars and cupolas, exhibit delicate mirror work, marble work, murals, wall paintings, silver work, inlay work and leftover of colored glass. The complex provides a view of the lake and Udaipur city from its upper terraces. The palaces within the complex are interlinked through a number of chalks and quadrangles with zigzag corridors planned in this fashion to avoid surprise attacks by enemies. Since it was Diwali time, there were way too many people than usual, and yeah, the City Palace was very crowded. walking for about 2 hours, we were so extremely tired that we headed straight to a restaurant and had some amazing lunch. But we had to wait for 45 minutes to 1 hour for the lunch to arrive. After resting for some time, I did a little outfit change and we headed to Lake Pichola. And let me tell you, the view there was absolutely mesmerizing. We went there at about 4 o'clock because the last boat ride is at about 5 p.m. And so we were able to catch the sunset and we headed straight to Jagmandir. So this boat takes a whole round around the Lake Pichola and shows you all of the banks. And we also got to see the city palace from the lake. After returning from Jagmandir, we had a delicious hot cup of tea and then we headed to the sweets shop to try some local Rajasthani sweets. So we tried out the famous Udaipur sweet called Gevar. On first tasting it, I felt it was okayish. And then next we went to do some shopping. So we went to this store called Bandhani. I will write down the names, but here we checked out some blankets and some saris and a few things here and there. These saris are made from bamboo fibers, custard apple fibers and many other things. Then I returned to the hotel and did a little photo shoot and then we went for dinner and called it a night.